Rob and Dennis have learned a valuable lesson while trying to make their way across India.
Put it in gear.
It is.
So how come it's rolling backwards?
Sometimes.
Get it!
You're an idiot.
Life's a ditch.
Look, Mom, no hate.
Reality TV star Boston Rob Mariano and monster trucker Dennis Anderson have found 48 ways. To go from Southern California, across South America and Africa, to the Arabian Peninsula. Now they're in India.
Get it!
Oh.
And they're on their way to Lake Picola in Udaipur.
All right, I'm king of the road here, you guys.
Rob Mariano and Dennis Anderson are circling the globe using 80 forms of transportation. Without repeating a single one, it's around the world in 80 ways.
You gotta be kidding me.
India marks our traveler's fourth and so far most crowded continent.
This is unbelievable, Rob.
Hold on. Back up.
They're starting in the city of Mumbai.
Jesus, man.
One of the world's biggest, with a population of over 20 million, and every one of them has to find a way to get around.
Dude, there is too many people here. This is freaking crazy.
For this leg of their around-the-world journey, Dennis and Rob have to travel 470 miles from Mumbai on India's west coast to Lake Picola outside the city of Udaipur.
Watch out now, don't get hurt. I don't want you to hurt your hand again. What did the doctor ever say about that? What was the diagnosis?
He just said I've got some pulled ligaments in it. It's not bad, it's banged up. I'm the left hand man now.
Dennis got a little banged up racing dune buggies in the Arabian desert.
It hurt like a bitch when it happened.
Watch out.
But he's none the worse for wear and ready to press on.
Dude, this is ridiculous. This is too many freaking people.
More lines in the road.
Oh, we don't even know if we're in the road or the sidewalk.
There's over 1 billion people live in India.
And 3/4 of them are driving these little tuk-tuks, it looks like. This is too many people, man. I want to get the hell out of here. We need to rent a couple of these things.
Yeah, I think we can get a good deal.
The guys need a way to get to Udaipur. Let's see if they can negotiate a good deal in India's business capital.
We want to rent these to take to Udaipur. How much?
This line.
I don't know.
Do you speak English? We need someone to translate Hindu. English?
Yeah.
Speak English?
Yeah.
We want to go to Udaipur. Can you ask these guys how much it would cost in US dollars to rent these?
Like 4,000 for both.
$4,000 US? Why so much?
Buying will be cheaper for you. Renting is too expensive.
Okay, how much to buy two of them?
90,000. Roughly it will be less than 2,000 US dollars.
Tell them we'll give them 1,500.
1,500 rupees.
No? These are not the only two tuk-tuks here in India. Look around. 1,800, and you got a deal.
That's good. Moolah moolah, boys.
Okay, 18.
They are now the proud owners of two tuk-tuks.
Jeez.
The tuk-tuk is basically a motorized version of a pulled rickshaw, which became popular in Japan in the 1860s. Tuk-tuks are a common sight throughout most of the world's developing countries. There are literally hundreds of variations on these baby taxis. Japan began exporting three-wheelers to Thailand in 1934, and they spread from there in popularity. It's not hard to see why they get a wallet-saving 82 miles per gallon.
This little dude's kind of tight in here. It's a hand start. This thing's got a two-stroke motor in it, a little three-speed transmission. You got to shift it by the knob, by the twist grip on the left side. Got the throttle on the right and a handbrake. This thing is a lot like one of those Italian scooters. Let's go, Dennis! off. I'm your buddy, okay? We're gonna get there one way or another.
Driving a couple of tuk-tuks around Mumbai.
This is crazy.
Might be the most dangerous way to travel these guys will ever find.
All right, Rob. You're driving like you live in India. Hey, mine's dying, you guys. Mine is dying. Mine just died. It acts like it ran out of fuel.
What are you doing?
I think it just quit, man. It's like it run out of gas. It started bogging like it lost fuel.
Let me pull over.
Hey! Go easy!
Huh?
Get out!
What?
Quit. He'll blow the freaking thing up. He's an idiot sometimes. You know, he's smart about some things, but stuff like that, dude, he don't care.
They made it to the outskirts of Mumbai.
We gotta adjust the clutch, this mother will not stop.
But Dennis is having a hard time wrangling his new ride.
Damn! Oh, you mother you.
Is he all right?
Blow it out your ass.
Do it!
This thing.
Hold the gas!
I know, the mother won't stop.
He doesn't want to drive it anymore, so he's trying to break it.
Oh, damn it.
Dude, look what you did.
I just hit the car in front of me, man. I couldn't help it. That's what I'm talking about. I got to fix the clutch.
Dude, you got bigger problems than the clutch.
Just that ain't
nothing. Keeping your eyes on the road. Watch where you're going.
I'm getting ready to throw a can of gas on this bitch.
Let me see what the problem is.
Wait a minute. I got my hand stuck in here. I ain't got but one good hand left, so
okay,
hold on.
Get it out. Let me try to start this.
Don't start it.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to adjust the clutch.
With your bare hands?
Yeah, that's all I got. I swear to God, I always get some kind of a bum piece of crap.
Are you really doing something or are you just playing in there?
No, I'm doing something, dude. All right, Rob, crank it up for me and don't rev on it, dude, okay? This thing's falling apart the farther we go. You see that on my elbow right there? That's from trying to crank this thing. Hey, 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 hey. Rob, come on, easy.
Well,
I got it,
some
I got
gas.
It. Come on. Please. Seriously, dude. Enough is a freaking enough.
How long before the next stop?
Until it breaks, okay? I need a break. I need a break from him for a while.
I mean, an ambulance.
Shut up and let's go. Come on.
Oh, now you're ready?
I'm not in the mood to tear up right now. I'm in the mood to get somewhere. And these horns in Rob's mouth are driving me freaking crazy.
3 hours into the trip, they've made some real progress towards their destination in Udaipur.
Damn it.
We're never gonna get there.
Dude, I gotta jerk it into gear. I have no clutch.
But Dennis's tuk-tuk keeps breaking down.
I don't think it's the clutch. I think it's the driver.
Get your ass in there and show me. I'll drive that one. There you go.
And Dennis is ready to melt down.
Rob! Hey, Rob! Rob!
Yeah?
Pull the clutch in for me. Stop freaking clowning around.
All right, here, you're difficult to work with.
What?
I don't know if anyone ever told you that before, but you're a little difficult to work with.
Dude, I'm going to take this freaking cast and knock you right beside the head in a minute. All right, get over here and pull this.
No, you pull it. I don't like the way you're talking to me. You're not asking nicely.
I got enough bull wrong right now without listening to your mouth, too.
Don't rev it. Don't rev it up too high.
Get your mouth in. Let's go. What are y'all doing? Y'all riding?
A couple of locals can't pass up the chance to ride with the gravedigger.
Do you have money?
You don't got money.
You got any gas? If you ain't got no gas, you ain't got no money. Get out.
If you got no cash, you ain't riding in Dennis's tuk-tuk.
Oh, yeah.
Clutch is better?
Yeah.
Good. Maybe that will improve your mood a little.
No, well, it's hard, man. You're trying to work on something. You got horns blowing and freaking mouth in the background.
Well, now we're getting out into the countryside. It should relax you a little. It's a highway coming up.
Good, I need some open road. Watch out for the cows. Driving in India is crazy, man. Coming down the wrong side of the road, what you doing?
Traffic in India is no joke.
This is a one-way street and we still got people coming to us.
Going the wrong way seems to be an accepted way of travel.
Watch this guy on his motorcycle.
Oh, shoot! Oh! God, help me!
But there are consequences.
Oh, God! Dude, he hit that thing head on.
That's what kind of happens, man. This is a dangerous place to be driving around here. We better go. These guys are coming around us, and there's the big trucks coming here on motorcycles and scooters. They just dodge in and out of the traffic like it's nothing, you know? Like, there's no rhyme or reason. Now the truck's driving off, look. Truck's leaving. There he goes. Oh, well. That's kind of scary. These little tuk-tuks. Wouldn't be a match for no big truck.
Not surprisingly, India leads the world in traffic-related deaths with over 130,000 fatalities every year. Fast and reckless is the way India rolls, and the law of the road can be boiled down to this.
Oh! Oh! Damn, he just hit him.
Might makes right. If you're on a scooter, don't mess with a truck.
Uh-oh.
But the biggest traffic hazard in India...
Holy cow!
...doesn't come with a motor. India is 80% Hindu, a religion that considers cows sacred animals. And when they get old, they're not let out to pasture, they're just let out.
Ooh, is that a cow or an ox? They look kind of weird.
Dennis can handle the cows.
Jesus, Rob! Damn it!
It's Rob who he's got to watch out for.
Here I go! Ah, you son of a bitch.
Installed it?
Yeah, installed. I just pulled a clutch.
You installed it.
No, you
couldn't have stalled it, right?
No, I didn't stall it.
He can't admit he stalled it going up there.
Rob.
Yes?
Rob, come here and help me for a minute.
What do you say?
Please.
Okay.
Put it in gear.
It is.
So how come it's rolling backwards?
Rob, get it!
You're an idiot.
The guys are tuk-tucking their way from Mumbai to Udaipur.
Jesus, bro! Damn it!
But for Dennis, it's one step forward, two steps back.
Put it in gear.
It is.
So how come it's rolling backwards?
Okay, there it goes. Rob! Damn it. Get it!
You're an idiot.
No.
Dennis.
Damn it, Rob. Thanks for the help.
What are you gonna do?
Nothing.
You want me to help you pull it out? I don't think you're gonna be able to drive
it out
of there.
Let me tell you right now, this thing was nice when we left. And it's a piece of now.
Mine is still nice.
Get some gas out, buddy.
It won't even crank.
Look, if we get it going, you need to turn the wheel, but there's a big steep edge right there.
Okay,
let's pull it backwards.
Back it up.
Three quarters of the way around the globe.
Hold on, you left it in gear.
Dennis and Rob still resemble a two-ring circus.
Okay, good.
Hi.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to help you get up out of this rut right here. See what I'm talking about? Do it easy.
Okay, ready?
Yeah. Go! Damn it.
When you're traveling.
Yeah, right.
Sometimes you have to rely upon the kindness of strangers.
Can you help us? We got stuck. We got to pull it out.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay? Where's the little guy? You drive. Come here. You're light. You drive. One, two, three.
Go. All right. Right on. Thank you, little man. Thank you, Mom. We're having all these kids and stopping. All right, thank you there, Pop. Appreciate it. Y'all have a good day.
They're on the road again.
Check us out.
But it's not long before curiosity brings them to a grinding halt.
What is this? What does it do? Is this sugar cane?
I know how it works, Dennis. Watch. Give it to me.
Oh, here we go.
Watch. Take one.
Watch out. You're getting ready to break your machine, okay?
Just put it in there like that. See, all the juice comes in there with the ice, and it makes it cold.
Watch your fingers, though. That thing will eat your hand up. So basically what it is, it's just a sugarcane press, and it's got these rollers in there with notches across them, and it squeezes all the sugar out of the sugarcane.
How much is that? $10 for how many? Two? Two glass? One glass? Want me to buy you a glass? I'm not drinking it, but if you want it, I'll buy it for you.
You're gonna drink one with me.
I ain't drinking that. Are you crazy?
Here you go, Rob.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Dennis continues his quest to eat his way around the world.
Good.
What's the matter with you? Why are you drinking that? I'm gonna return mine. Thank you, but no thank you. I didn't drink out of it. I don't want it.
Santa.
Ah. He's still drinking it. What's wrong with him? Don't come coming to me when you have you know what later on.
This is all natural.
Oh, yeah. That's natural.
Sure.
Look how naturally clean that is. What is wrong with you? You're making a mess, too. Crazy, isn't he?
Show him how you wash it. Show him how you wash. Show him the sanitary procedure. Look at this.
Nice.
Look at him. Right? Disinfectant. All done. Yay, again.
All right, let's go. It was really pretty good. I hope it doesn't make me sick, but it wasn't bad. Thanks, buddy. Give me some. Yeah, go like this. Punya. Yes, sir.
Ten hours and 450 miles later, the guys are right outside Udaipur.
The blue horn cow. That's pretty cool. This has been one long drive, I can tell you that. Hey, cow, better get your butt out of the road. We'll make hamburger out of you.
I don't know about you, but I'm ready to get out of these things.
I know it. I'm about tucked out, buddy.
Tucked out.
Yeah.
How long have you been saving that joke for?
I've already said it about five times. You just haven't heard me.
The tuk-tuk served them well and got them to Udaipur. Now they gotta find Lake Pecola. And they need to bag some more waves before this leg of their trip is over.
See, Dennis, a lot more relaxed here than in Mumbai.
My butt, dude. This is a cluster. Look at this. Watch, he's gonna get us run over, man.
Udaipur is a small city for India, only around 3 million people, but it's still the size of Chicago, big enough for two guys to get lost.
Bye. Ridiculous, man.
We need to ask somebody how to get to Lake Pecola. Excuse me. Do you know how to get to Lake Pecola?
I don't know.
Lake Pecola.
Hey.
Lake Pecola?
Get the second thing.
This way?
London.
Thank you. Okay.
Wonder how far that is.
It can't be that much further now.
Udaipur in Chicago might be the same size, but you won't find the guys next way on Michigan Avenue.
Dude, that's an Indian elephant. Look at this, look at this.
Oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
I can't get up on that, dude. That's crazy.
Dude, look at that. He's yawning. Look at his mouth.
I wonder if they ever get mad at him. So you need to love on it, man, and give it a little treat.
Look at the decorating the elephant.
Oh, yeah, wow. Will she let me do this? Hey. Hey, baby.
Dennis can't help himself. Even an elephant can be customized.
How do I get up there?
All right. Look here. GD, grave digger. It's the elephant digger. Dennis, that's me. See? Dennis right here.
As a form of transportation, elephants are the Mack trucks of the animal kingdom. Typically, it's the less aggressive female that gets domesticated. The wilder males are used for military purposes.
Hold the ladder. Holy crap.
But elephants do have their dark sides. In India, there are a number of attacks attributed to groups of rogue elephants out on a rampage. They kill hundreds of people every year.
This is scary. Is this thing tied on here good? Rob! Rob!
Yeah?
Stop screwing around and get the hell on that elephant.
Really?
Okay. Sam. Sam. Sam.
Oh, my God. Okay, no problem.
See, now, Rob, that's what a monster truck feels like right there.
This is pretty cool.
All right, I'm king of the road here, you guys. Hey, this thing is growling. Rob, damn, mine's growling. They're gonna get out here in all this traffic. This thing's gonna freak out.
Dennis!
Yeah?
Is my chair leaning the wrong way? I feel like you're gonna fall over every 2 seconds.
I can't hear you, Rob. Come on up here. Children, get out of the way. Come on here. Keep going. Keep going. Wonk, 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 wonk.
Hey!
Look at the power lines, Rob.
We need to get off.
Look at the power lines right there.
I see them.
So if you get hung up in them, buddy, you need to get off. That's another way.
Dennis and Rob abandon ship before they get electrocuted.
My baby. Will you stop smelling and touching and kissing everything?
The guys still have to find a way to get to Lake Piccola.
Look at this, Rob.
Yeah. This looks like it's right up your alley.
And we put an unusual one right in their path.
That is cool, man. That's a 24.28. We use these in the mud, man, on some of our mud boggers at home.
You want to race?
Sure.
Come on.
Let's do it.
Where to?
Let's go to the archway, right there at the end of the road.
Okay. What are we betting?
You know those tattoos that the women have got
the
on
Hannah?
Them? Yeah.
The women tattoos?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes. So I think the loser should get either the other guy's name or just put loser on the side of their face.
All right, let's do it. Excuses are starting already.
These monster trikes work by using two chains to power the front wheel. A chain from the pedal runs up to an axle under the handlebars. Two chains run down to either side of the front wheel. When the pedals are turned, the power is transferred to the front wheel, making this trike go.
Ready?
Ah! This thing doesn't have good steering. He's cheating again.
Whoa! My chain fell off. Help me. Ready?
The boys picked up a couple of monster trikes to race to Lake Piccola.
Whoa! My chain fell off.
And it looks like Dennis is heading for a rare win against the ultra-competitive Rob.
Listen, I need you guys to help me. Come on, come on! Ah. No, 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 no! Help me! Go! Ah. Wait!
You gotta be on it, Rob!
My chain broke!
You gotta be on it!
My chain's broken!
Come on! Go!
Go, go, go! Go, go, go!
Come on!
Go, 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 go! Yeah! Woo! Yeah! What a race!
You cheated!
I didn't cheat!
You cheated! I never got off!
No, I never!
You cheated! I never got off!
I said first across the line! Yes!
Rob! Woo! Rob again!
Man.
Robbed again by Rob.
I was faced with adversity, and I overcame. I got the locals to help me. It was when I crashed into you that my chain broke.
Yeah. Boo, boo.
Man, those flowers are gonna look great on you.
That's bull.
That's a winning way.
That's a cheating way right there.
Bet's a bet.
I like to pop you in the mouth sometime.
They raced. Dennis lost.
Excuse me, do you guys do henna? The henna tattoo?
Yes.
And now he's got a bet to honor.
My friend wants to get a head of tattoo on his face.
Hold on, I really don't want to get one. I kind of have to get one. Okay, come. Yeah, what are we going to put on it?
Sit down. Over here.
Hold on, Rob, not on both sides. This sucks, Rob.
For over 6,000 years, Mediterranean and Asian women have been decorating their bodies with dye made from the flowering henna plant.
You gonna put some flowers? That's pretty. You know you wanna laugh.
She's telling me no.
Stay still or you're gonna mess it up.
Yeah, I hate you, Rob. Why is it when I lose, there's always something tragic we gotta do?
I don't know. You're the one that set the stakes. This'll wash off in like 6 to 8 weeks, right?
My ass. I hate you right now. It's all right. It goes around, comes around.
She's actually very skilled. Turn to the side. Let me see. Oh, beautiful. Okay. I think that's enough. Okay, let's not overdo it.
Where's the mirror at?
How long?
What's on it?
It's a nice floral arrangement and some leaves. And it looks like a mermaid tail on the bottom.
And what else? Thanks a lot.
All right, let's go. You're a good sport, Dennis.
Dennis and Rob could walk for hours in this strange and crowded city and never find a bathtub, let alone the lake they're looking for.
Dennis, we need to get up on top of that mountain, and then we'll be able to see where we're going.
Rob gets an idea. When in doubt, head for higher ground.
Let's go up there, and we'll find Lake Pecola.
That's a long ways.
You're right. We need to see if we can find our way to get up this hill.
We've gone just about every way in town, haven't we?
Everything except for this.
In Udaipur, where there's an ox cart, there's a way.
What is that?
Can we rent these?
Show
How
you.
Much?
My dad, 50.
120. Okay, just put it in your pocket, smile, and say yes, okay? Good? He's not happy, but just get it before he changes his mind.
Easy, boy. Easy, boy.
Man, I can't see where I'm going.
We need to get out of this city, man. Ah, man's on me.
Is he really?
Yeah, right now. That smells nice and fresh. He's got a big old turd right here in my face. There's his butthole. Here's my face. This far apart. Let me sniff that. Ah!
Ox carts have been a way to travel since man first domesticated animals. They don't cover as much ground as a horse, but they're stronger and calmer. Definitely an advantage in the crowded urban streets of India.
I got flies following this ass here. It's a little juicy. We're on the road again.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up.
Come on. All right, get your ass around now. Keep blowing your damn horn. I'm sick of horns, man. I'm ready to get out of here.
Hey, Dennis.
Yes, sir.
I think my ox is getting tired. He's slowing down a lot.
Downshift. You got to take his tail like this. You got downshifting. Come on. Come on here.
We should bail on these guys.
You
Give
think?
Me a rest.
All right.
Bring him in. Bring him in. Bring him in. Off the road.
Don't be ugly.
Don't tease him. Come on.
You better behave yourself, you hear me?
Leave him alone, Dennis.
You act just like you're a commander here. Hard-headed as a bull.
Rob might have pulled the plug on the oxen too soon.
This is ridiculous, dude. Look how much farther we gotta go.
They still have half a mountain to walk up.
Hey, thanks for stopping.
Yeah, appreciate the ride. Inconsiderate freaking people. Gotta be kidding me, after all of this, and they built a set of steps like this? That's bull. No, keep your hands to yourself right now. Wow, that's a long hike, dude, to get all that material up here to build this.
The guys are at Udaipur's Monsoon Palace. built by a Maharaja who liked to watch the clouds roll in during the rainy season.
Look at that view, though, dude. You know, Rob, when we were down in the city, I think we were in that whole big old mass of buildings and stuff right there in the middle.
That is where we were. And if you look over to the right, there's Lake Pecola.
That is cool, man.
So all we had to do was go right.
I know it. We'd have been there by now. But you know what? We didn't go the right way, but we didn't go the wrong way either. We just went the long way.
Go! Go!
Coming up.
Go! 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 Go!
Stop!
It's a new day, and so far, the guys have knocked off four new waves. They took a ride on a couple of tuk-tuks.
Get it, get it! No.
Tried out two pachyderms.
He's yawning.
Raced monster trikes.
He's cheating again.
Hitched a ride on a couple of ox carts.
That smells nice and fresh.
They also climbed a mountain to get a view of their final destination.
Look at that view, dude.
Lake Pecola.
This is it. This is Lake Pecola. This is what we've been trying to get to.
Lake Pecola is man-made and only 33 feet at its deepest point.
This is where the royal family used to vacation. What do you think?
It's pretty cool, man. I love these boats over here.
See that palace over there?
Yeah.
That's an Oberoi hotel over there.
We really? Figured they'd yeah. compete anyway.
That'd be a sweet place to stay right there.
So we gave them a challenge. Race, and the winner gets to sleep at the world-famous Oberoi Hotel. The other, this hostel.
2 hours, you have to build your own watercraft, and first okay. one to get there wins.
It's a bet.
All right, let's do it.
The guys head out to scrounge for boat building materials.
Everybody grab a blue thing, let's put them in the truck. Everybody grab one.
About 1,000 for four of them.
Yep.
I'm gonna have to put me some of these boards, maybe. Like that.
This will be the deck.
You got a big inner tube? You do?
Yeah.
Go get it.
Okay.
English? You guys speak English? I need a paddle.
You know, oar.
No. Okay. I mean, I don't know how I'm gonna go anywhere without an oar.
At this point, it looks like I'm spending the night in the hostel.
All right, these.
500 rupees each.
400 each.
No, no, 500.
Huh?
500.
Please. Put it down here, total it all up, and let's see what it is. Now, you know, getting these guys down on this, I ain't got time to mess around. Let's roll. All right, let's load it up. Close the gate.
All right, let's get this old chuck-chuck moving, baby.
You need to get off your phone and keep going. All right, here's Rob. He's right behind me.
Over here. That's good. How'd you do?
Oh, I got a heavy watercraft here. Right.
Oh, my goodness.
We grabbed some locals to help the guys out.
Hey, right here. Hey, right here. Right here. Get all this. Right here, right here. Yeah,
come on. Yeah. Bring it down there in the middle.
Just set it right here.
There you go.
Yep, put it right there.
Give me. Grab one.
Yeah, nice paddle there, Slickaroo.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't keep taking my now, because I'll cut your raft in half. We gotta keep eye on these.
Basically, what we have here is a two pontoon style. In the center, we have some blue plastic containers to hold us up, and of course, a chair that's tilted forward for maximum thrust.
Mine's gonna be a little heavy. I got heavy planking on it. We got two oars, so it'll be two man powered. It's gonna be me and you. All the way around. Got it?
Because of Dennis's broken hand, he's taking on a first mate for the race.
Mine's a transformer. If plan A is too slow, I jump in plan B, and I get going. I'm gonna get his ass this time.
The water. We're going to go right here. Okay, go over that way.
Hey, it's a successful launch.
All right, come on.
Okay. It's on. Dennis, you ready?
I think so.
Grab your paddle.
Go. Come on, go. Come on. Get on your knees. Go like this. It looks like scared. Get down like this and give it hell.
Dennis's first mate isn't working out so well.
Paddle, man. Come on. Turn the hand over.
The other way.
Look at Dennis brought someone that doesn't even know how to row.
Damn it. You ain't worth a dude. Right here. Hey. Right here. Hey.
Cheating can be contagious. First, Dennis hitches a ride, and then Rob.
Get on the back. Get on the back. Go.
Hey. Okay, go.
Come on. Come on. Sorry I was cussing at you, dude, but you were weaker than I thought. I'm an old fat guy, and I'll wear your ass out.
Faster. Faster.
Come on.
I didn't know it was going to bring a 30 horsepower. Go, go, go! More! Go, go!
No, go!
Go!
Rob turns pirate and jumps on board with Dennis.
Go, go, go!
Stop!
And Dennis loses his mind. Dennis and Rob are racing across Lake Pecola for the right to room at a five-star hotel.
Right here.
Go, go, go. More. Go, go.
No, go.
Because of all the raw sewage dumping into Lake Pecola.
Stop! Stop!
The last thing you'd want to do is jump in.
I can't believe you jumped in. You almost had me, Dennis! Almost!
You stupid mother f***er! Get out of here! Get the f*** out of here!
Come here. Be careful. It's all right, man. They have great showers at the hostels in India.
That's the stupidest freaking boat drivers I could ever have.
It was the best part when I overtook him for the win. Yeah!
Screw you!
Don't be a sore loser.
No, listen, you didn't finish with your raft, okay?
I finished
with mine.
No, the, and that was raft like, back there, I can see
crap.
It from here.
That's all right, that was plan B right there. It's a part of my raft. You didn't have nothing. Nothing off of your raft, so I got here first.
How do you say enjoy the hostel in Hindi?
Bull crap. How do you say cheated and robbed once again?
Hostel ka mazalo.
Hostel ka mazalo. Okay?
Kiss this ka mazalo.
Rack up another loss for Dennis. But another way goes in the books. To the victor go the spoils. Then Rob is about to get very spoiled.
So this is the Udai Villas?
Yes.
Excellent. What's with the guy with the umbrella? Is it in case it rains?
No. We definitely escort all our guests with umbrellas whenever they're under the sun.
Well, it's a little bit different, but I'll go with it.
Thank you. I hope you like it.
You know what I like most about it?
What?
Dennis doesn't have one.
While Rob gets treated like a Maharaja,
Is this a hostel? Can I get a room here?
Dennis is about to regret ever leaving North Carolina.
Jeez. Uh-oh. You gotta be kidding me. You have any single rooms? A room for one person?
No.
Jeez.
Welcome to your lovely suite.
Oh, thank you. It's gorgeous. This is like a house. Who else is staying here?
Just you.
Wow.
This is your swimming pool. Over this is Lake Pichola.
Who's that? Who are you?
Hello, I'm your personal butler.
Oh my God. Look at that toilet. That's a poop hole right there, dude. I'll crap in my pants before I use this place. It's ridiculous. Look at this shower. Now really, how are you supposed to take a shower in there and look, it's down here by your waist? This is ridiculous. Really.
So, is there anything I can get you?
Yeah, so like a cold beer and a Monte Cristo number 2.
Is it all right to lay on this? You get itching and burning or anything?
Ah, it's a little bit dirty.
But man, you know, it's like a prison bed.
Oh,
look at this. Ah, damn.
Hold on. Turn the music down.
Might be my mama.
No. Yellow.
Dennis.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Loud in the background over there.
What's going on? It's late. Get ready to go to bed.
You're living it up, buddy.
I'm telling you, this is great. The showers, man. I'm telling you, they've got good water pressure.
Oh,
nice,
I'm sorry.
Nice hot showers.
Any bathrooms, dude? They're really the least.
Thank you. You're right, Ashman.
Who are you talking to? My butler.
Yeah.
Okay, well, good.
I'm glad you're still having a good time. I was just calling to say goodnight, and I'll meet up with you in the morning, all right, buddy?
Don't let the bed bugs bite, okay?
All right, no problem, dude. Ain't no bugs here. This place is awesome. You would not believe it.
Good night, buddy.
All right, loser. Good night.
All right. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Dennis and Rob carved a big chunk out of India, going from Mumbai to Udaipur. As for ways to travel,
we're just rolling.
They found 5. Tuk-tuk.
This is crazy.
Elephant.
All right, I'm king of the road here, you guys.
Monster trikes.
My chain fell off.
Ox cart.
That smells nice and fresh.
And homemade rafts. It all adds up to 53 in the bag.
Faster, faster!
And 27 more to go.
Here we are in India now, and I'm telling you, man, there is just way too many damn people here. Now I know what a tuk-tuk is made for. It's made for places that's got 6 million people downtown, or however many people they have here.
We're driving these tuk-tuks around, and it is literally organized chaos. They have stoplights and traffic lights and lines on the road, but nobody obeys anything.
The madness of the traffic, a truck coming up the wrong way and hitting a guy head on with a scooter, I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. And everybody kind of drove off, like sweeping to the side, and we just kind of moved on, you know? And that to me is a culture shock, you know? It's like, you gotta be kidding me.